Georgia Pageant.
Live from Columbus, Georgia, Campbell Soup is proud to bring you the 46th annual Miss Georgia Pageant. Since 1944, the Miss Georgia Pageant has been the largest source of scholarships for women all over Georgia. Not just another pageant, but the original. And the Miss Georgia selected here tonight will go on to compete against other state winners in Atlantic City, where she just may become your next Miss America. The 1990 Miss Georgia Pageant is being brought to you in part by Suzuki Motors, Far More, C&S Bank, Angel Soft, Coca-Cola, and your local Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Now, stay with us, because we're headed for the future. Gentlemen, the contestants and future Miss Georgia.
I'm Carrie Flowers, Miss Albany, and my pageant is held in Albany.
I'm Tamara Tanner, Miss Altamaha, and my pageant is held in Claxton.
I'm Angela Alves, Miss Americas, and my pageant is held in Americas.
I'm Julie Morgan, Miss Andrew College, and my pageant is held in Cuthbert.
I'm Natalie Hendricks, Miss Armstrong State College. My pageant is held in Savannah.
I'm Denise Hathaway, Miss Augusta, and my pageant is held in Augusta.
I'm Kelly Schubert, Miss Brunswick, Golden Isles, and my pageant is held in Brunswick.
I'm Skye Baxley, Miss Bullock County, and my pageant is held in Statesboro.
I'm Tamara Tesh, Miss Central Georgia. My pageant is held in Thomaston.
I'm Erica Bowman, Miss Cherokee County, and my pageant is held in Canton.
I'm Casey Strickland, Miss Coastal Georgia, and my pageant is held in St. Mary's.
I'm Michelle
Savannah, and my pageant is held in Savannah.
I am Lisa Johnson, Miss Southeast Georgia, and my pageant is held in Swainsboro.
I'm Denise Daniels, Miss Southwest Georgia, and my pageant was held in Moultrie.
I'm April Adams, Miss Stone Mountain, and my pageant is held in Lawrenceville.
I'm Amy Stubbs, Miss Tatnall County, and my pageant is held in Reidsville.
For the 1990 Miss Georgia title. With announcement of the 10 semifinalists and their swimsuit, talent, and evening gown competition. Right after this, Fight's Mistress of Ceremonies and 1988 Miss America, Kehlani Rae Ratko.
Thank you. And welcome to the Miss Georgia pageant. Wow, what a crowd. Don't they look great? Wonderful. It's a real pleasure for me to be here in Georgia for the oldest continuing Miss America preliminary in the country. This is the 46th year that the Miss Georgia pageant has originated from right here in Columbus, Georgia. At this time, I would like to introduce to you another very special guest, someone who'll be co-hosting tonight's show with me. Please welcome Atlanta's favorite weatherman from WAGA-TV, Mr. Paul Osmond.
Hello and welcome. Welcome. Hi, Kehlani. How are you doing?
Hello. Great crowd.
I'm really excited tonight. I am really, really excited tonight. And I know these beautiful young ladies are ready. They've been here all week competing in various phases of competition. Tonight is the final phase of competition. And before the end of the night, we'll be crowning a new Miss Georgia. And who knows, we may also be crowning the next Miss America.
That's right. That's right. He's right. You know, it all starts right here. Tonight there will be a new Miss Georgia crowned, and very well, she may be going on to becoming Miss America. You know, I understand that you're quite a prognosticator.
Oh.
So, do you have any forecast for us tonight?
Well, I'll tell you what, Kehlani, it's definitely a high-pressure situation.
That's for sure. I know I feel the pressure. I'm sure the audience feels the pressure. And I know that these ladies feel it because over the last three nights, they have competed already in swimsuit, talent, and evening gown competitions. They've already met with our judges earlier this week for a seven-minute scored interview. The 10 contestants accumulating the most points over the last three nights will be the ones to move into the 10 semifinalist position. If the judges are ready, we'll announce our semifinalists for tonight. I'm excited.
Excited too.
do you feel? You feel excited? Yeah. Talk about pressure.
Okay, here we go. The 10 semifinalists are Miss Tipton, Kendra Tomlinson.
Judges have also selected six other ladies they feel were exceptional in the in their talent presentations and deserve special recognition at this time. Those special talent award winners will get a $450 scholarship.
And they are
together.
Special talent winners. Congratulations, ladies.
You know, Kehlani, the excitement is really building, and the excitement is all over Georgia's. Every household in Georgia can actually view the Miss Georgia Pageant 1990. We want to recognize some of the affiliates, some of the stations carrying this 1990 presentation. They are WAGA-TV in Atlanta, WXTX-TV in Columbus, WRDW in Augusta, WGXA in Macon, WJCL in Savannah, and WALB in Albany. Let's give them a round of applause.
Thank you. Well, as you can see, this has already been an exciting week, but actually the excitement is just beginning. Before we go any further, we'd like to introduce the people who are responsible for selecting Miss Georgia. Our distinguished panel of judges, let's meet them now.
Marie Hansen is a veteran judge of over 13 Miss America state pageants. Currently, she serves as president of the Miss Kansas pageant. From Pratt, Kansas, welcome Marie Hansen. A dentist from Hot Springs, Arkansas, Dr. Ronald Splen, has judged over 20 Miss America state preliminaries. He has been associated with the Miss Arkansas pageant since 1971. Welcome, Dr. Ronald Splen. John W. Lawson, a resident of Kingston, New York, is a former president of the Miss New York State Pageant. He comes to us with more than 30 years of service to the Miss America program. Welcome, John Lawson. Larry Ossenkopf is chairman of the board of the Miss Nebraska Scholarship Pageant. He has held various positions in state pageant programs in both Kansas and Nebraska for 18 years. From Kearney, Nebraska, please welcome Larry Ossenkopf. Loran Weber has been active in the Miss Missouri pageant since 1972, serving in various capacities. Currently, she is a member of the board of directors of the Miss Missouri Scholarship Pageant. Please welcome Loran Weber. And our auditors for this evening are from the Columbus accounting firm of Robinson Grimes and Company. Please welcome Ron Thomas and Greg Voynich. And there you have the 1990 Miss Georgia panel of judges. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to present to you your reigning Miss Georgia, Jamie Crouch. Exciting swimsuit competition after a word from your local station.
If you ever dreamed of wearing the Miss Georgia USA crown, your dream could come true. Special Occasions presents the Miss Southern Coastal Empire pageant. Entry deadlines vary, so register now for the only official preliminary to the Miss Georgia USA pageant. Any single Georgia resident ages 18 months to 26 years is eligible. Winners of teen and Miss categories advance to the state finals. Dreams really do come true, so register now at Special Occasions.
Now, baby.
Here's John Laylock.
Oh,
ladies are about ready for the swimsuit competition, so stay tuned. We'll be right back after this.
Swimsuit competition with our 10 semifinals.
That's right, Paul. If the judges are ready, we will begin tonight's swimsuit competition. Miss Tifton, Kendra Tomlinson. Kendra enjoys singing, cooking, and traveling. To unwind and relax, she also enjoys taking long walks and playing tennis with friends. This is Miss Tifton, Kendra Tomlinson. Miss Armstrong State College, Natalie Hendricks. Natalie enjoys singing, dancing, and Southern style cooking. She is a weekday weekend news anchor for WJCL TV 22 in Savannah. This is Miss Armstrong State College, Natalie Hendricks. Miss Douglas County, Danann Sims. She enjoys sharing her talents the most with the children at the Athens Battered Women's Shelter, where she is a volunteer. She also enjoys playing intramural softball and football games. Her hobbies include collecting cat figurines and shopping for bargains. This is Miss Douglas County, Danann Sims. Miss Warner Robbins, Tony Henson. Tony enjoys all sports. She was named All-American Defensive Player at the National Invitational Flag Football Sugar Bowl. She enjoys singing, playing the piano, and composing songs. This is Miss Warner Robbins, Tony Henson. Miss Thomasville, Dean Peruse. Dean enjoys public speaking, playing the piano, and the bassoon. She also collects U.S. Mint coins, first aid cover stamps, and Madame Alexander International dolls. This is Miss Thomasville, Dean Peruse. Miss Northeast Georgia, Darla Pruitt. Darla recently graduated magna cum laude and plans to attend Georgetown University School of Law. She has worked as a production assistant with PM Magazine. Darla currently trains in the Olympic-style circuit training, plyometrics. This is Miss Northeast Georgia, Darla Pruitt. Miss Southeast Georgia, Lisa Johnson. Lisa enjoys flag football, fishing, and water skiing. She collects music boxes and enjoys singing, especially in her church. Her particular interest has been as a Special Olympics volunteer, which she feels not only helps others, but better prepares her to obtain her goal to become a recreational therapist. This is Miss Southeast Georgia, Lisa Johnson. Miss Greater Atlanta, Colette Nolan. Colette is a spokesperson for the Association for Retarded Citizens and the American Cancer Society. She enjoys modeling and hopes to obtain an MBA from Emory University. This is Miss Greater Atlanta, Colette Nolan. Miss Rome, Melanie Helton. Melanie enjoys swimming, water skiing, and snow skiing. To stay in shape, she enjoys aerobicizing, dancing, speed walking, and pumping iron. Some of her favorite hobbies include singing, playing the piano, collecting dolls, and being a golf cheerleader. This is Miss Rome, Melanie Helton. Miss DeKalb County, Melanie Hobbs. Melanie works as a model and entertainer in Atlanta and is a member of the Georgia State University cheerleading squad. She collects elephant figurines and ceramic masks. She is calorie conscious but quick to admit she's a gourmet snacker. This is Miss DeKalb County, Melanie Hobbs.
Don't you dare go away. The popular and all-important talent competition is coming up next. And now, please welcome John Blaylock and Jamie Price. After a word from your local station.
Welcome back. The talent competition accounts for 40% of the overall point total, therefore, Kehlani making it very, and I do say very, very important.
Yes. So if the judges are ready, our first talent presentation comes from the musical Golden Rainbow. Kendra feels that rainbows are symbolic of hopes, dreams, and the promise of things to come. Here singing her rendition of Golden Rainbow, please welcome Miss Tifton, Kendra Tomlinson.
I'll never ask again if you give me this one thing. I'll want no more if you give me this dream. I'm asking, I'm begging, please. Golden rainbow, shine above me. Once is all I'm asking for. Golden
make me lucky, make my golden dreams come true. Break the clouds and bring the sunshine, I'm depending on you. I'll never ask again if you give me this one thing. I want the Lord to give me this dream. One little turn of luck and I'll really be something. I want it, I need it, I'm asking, I'm begging, please. Golden raindrop, come up shining. Bring me fortune if you know how. If you're ever gonna touch me, golden rainbow, won't you make it now? Come up shining, bring me fortune if you know how. If you're ever gonna touch me, golden rainbow, won't you make it now? Make it now.
Les Miserables, a Broadway musical which shows a special undying love, a strong love, of a young girl for a man and her country. Listen now as our next contestant portrays the young girl and tells us she's on her own. Please welcome Miss Armstrong State College, Natalie Hendricks.
We'd like to thank the City of Columbus, the Miss Georgia Pageant patrons, WAGA-TV Atlanta, Jay Pontiac, and Columbus Civic League. Thank you for your support. Danann will portray the character of Musetta from the Italian opera La Boheme as she sings Quando Mien Voseletta. The first line of her song translates, When I go alone through the street, the people stop and stare. Please welcome Miss Douglas County, Danann Sims. Thank Birch and Hatfield, Holiday Inn Airport, Ultra Security, Neon Cow, and the historic Columbus Hilton. Thank you. We appreciate the support this week. The Phantom of the Opera tells a story of an innocent young love threatened by the obsession of the mad phantom. Imagine yourself at the setting as Tony portrays Christine, pleading with the phantom to love her. Join her as she sings the haunting love ballad, All I Ask of You. Please welcome Miss Warner Robins, Toni Henson.
No more talk of darkness. Forget these wide-eyed fears. I'm here. Nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you, beside you, to guard you and to guide you. Say you love me every waking moment. Turn my head with talk of summertime. Say you need me.
We'll be right back after a word from your local station.
And lifts the spirit. Perhaps his greatest composition was his Piano Concerto No. 1 in B-flat minor, Opus 23. This stirring piece transcends the years from the grandeur of the 19th century Russia to the harmony of a 21st century world working in concert toward world peace. Here to play this concerto is Miss Thomasville, Dean Peruse.
And Albright's florist. Also special thanks to Braswell Jewelers, the Columbus JCs, Frederico and Frederico Leone Footwear, and a special thanks to the Wedding Bell of Rome. Thank you, Risa, for providing the gowns this week for me. The music sensation Phantom of the Opera tells a story of an innocent young love threatened by the obsession of the mad phantom. This theme of beauty and evil is now brought to life by our next contestant, as she performs the haunting ballad, Think of Me. Please welcome Miss Northeast Georgia, Darla Pruitt.
Free.
Special thanks to Farrah TV, Bill Hurd Chevrolet, Arts Music, the Civic School of Dance, and Dr. George Shannon. Thank you. When Lois Lane met Superman, she wondered in song about this friend from another star. Lisa Johnson wonders tonight whether her dreams for a similar extraordinary experience are obvious as she seeks the Miss Georgia title, asking, "Can you read my mind?" Please welcome Miss Southeast Georgia, Lisa Johnson.
From your local station.
So if you're missing out on vegetables and can't get to eat them, you can drink them instead. One glass of delicious V8 juice provides a serving of vegetables to help balance your diet.
Better serve him a V8.
Drink V8. Keep your diet straight.
Competition. Kaylani, who's next?
From the Broadway musical Jacques Brel, Miss Greater Atlanta will sing the inspiring "If We Only Have Love." Please welcome Miss Greater Atlanta, Colette Nolan. Yeah.
Yeah.
Bambino Caro is an aria from Puccini's opera Gianni Schicchi. It is a story of a young girl pleading with her daddy to let her marry the man of her dreams. It translates, "Oh, my beloved daddy, won't you be kind and help me? I love Ronaldo. I'd rather die without him. Help me, dear God, I pray." Please give a warm welcome to Miss Rome, Melanie Helton. I'd like to mention some of the sponsors who are helping to make tonight's broadcast possible. Special thanks to Campbell Soup Company, Suzuki Motors, Coca-Cola, Farmore, Angel Soft, and CNS Bank. Thank you so much. Melanie Hobbs presents her philosophy of life by sharing through sight and sound why she has the music in me. Please welcome Miss DeKalb County, Melanie Hobbs.
No troubles in my life, no foolish dreams to make me cry. I'm never frightened or worried. I know I'll always get by. I hear,
That completes the talent competition. Next is the beautiful evening gown competition. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with Jamie Price, the beautiful evening gown competition, and the excitement of crowning our new Miss Georgia. You.
Registered nurse and future hospice director, I am grateful to the Miss America program for the scholarships and experience gained at the local, state, and national level. For these women competing tonight and for hundreds more in the Miss Georgia program, this is not an end, but a beginning. Miss Georgia awards nearly $30,000 in scholarships annually. Since those involved with the Miss Georgia pageant are volunteers, your contribution will go directly to the contestants. With your support, you will be helping young women achieve their educational goals and make a lot of dreams come true. If you want to be a part of a young woman's success, please call 404-322-2315. When we return, you'll see tonight's final phase of competition, evening gown. But first, a word from our sponsors.
Semifinalists are about to begin the final phase of competition.
As part of the evening gown competition, each contestant will be asked a question that has been selected from the subject matter discussed in her private interview. So if the judges are ready, we will begin tonight's evening gown competition with Miss Tifton, Kendra Tomlinson. Kendra, with the percentage of our aging population rising, what challenges do we face in the future?
We are in what I consider the graying of America. The baby boom generation is over. And at this time, we have 27 million people over the age of 65. What I feel that we can do for these people is just to let them know that we care. They are there, and they are concerned about what is going on around in our world. They're concerned about political issues and about AIDS. And just through volunteerism, visiting them at their homes or possibly residents in nursing homes, we just need to let them know that we care, that they are in our society, and they still have a very vital part about what is going on in the world around them.
Thank you, Kendra. Her talent is a vocal performance of Golden Rainbow. She is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Herman Tomlinson. There you have Miss Tifton, Kendra Tomlinson. Miss Armstrong State College, Natalie Hendricks. Natalie. How can we as Americans preserve our historic heritage for future generations?
So many people have the misconception that historic preservation means hiding something under a glass dome or putting it behind a red rope in a museum, when it is ever so much more important. We can do everything possible by using all of our resources around us to enhance our heritage and our country for our future generations to see what we see now as growth and progress.
Thank you, Natalie. Her talent is a vocal performance of On My Own. She is the daughter of Mrs. Claire Oliver and Mr. Lewis Hendricks. There you have Miss Armstrong State College, Natalie Hendricks. Miss Douglas County, Danann Sims. Danann, how would you, as a music educator, promote the importance of the performing arts in a child's education?
As an educator, I have seen so many children receive such joy from the art of performing. It is not only a fun subject, it is an integrated subject, it is incorporated, and it is what brings all other subjects together because it deals with the whole person. Children can reach within themselves and create and find talents, and those that may not be able to achieve academically can always excel as a performer, especially in my classroom.
Thank you, Danann. Her talent is a vocal performance of Cuando Me Envolseta. She is a daughter of Mr. and Mrs. L. Sims. There you have Miss Douglas County, Danann Sims. Miss Warner Robbins, Tony Henson. Tony. One of the most serious social issues facing our nation is drug abuse. How can we as individuals deal with this problem in our local communities?
Well, you know, actions speak louder than words. The young people of today follow our example. It is up to us to set the example, abstinence from drugs. I feel like the schools need to be educated for the abuse of drugs. Thank you.
Thank you, Tony. Her talent is a vocal performance of All I Ask of You. She is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Hilton Henson. There you have Miss Warner Robbins, Tony Henson. Miss Thomasville, Dean Peruse. Dean, no longer can we take for granted America's position as the most dominant superpower. How can we achieve greater global understanding of people abroad?
Right now, the understanding between peoples throughout the world is very important. And I feel the best way to reach out to other people is through cultural exchanges, not only in the business sector, but also in the school systems and with ordinary citizens promoting what they believe in, the American ideal.
Thank you, Dean. Her talent is a piano performance of Piano Concerto No. 1 in B-flat minor. She is a daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Donald Peruse. There you have Miss Thomasville Dean Peruse. Miss Northeast Georgia Darla Pruitt. Darla, illiteracy is one of the greatest problems we are facing as a nation. What can we as individuals do to help reverse this trend?
Illiteracy is definitely one of the greatest problems that we face in America. One out of every five adults is functionally illiterate, and the cost to society is estimated to be at $225 billion per year. I think we need to make the public more aware that this is such a grave problem through national campaigns and the media. Secondly, I think we should pass legislation so that those who go to prison must be literate before they are released. And then finally, I think we need to encourage those who are illiterate to get the help they need. Being illiterate is nothing to be ashamed of, but not getting the help you need is.
Thank you. It's a vocal performance of Think of Me. She is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Cecil Pruitt. There you have Miss Northeast Georgia, Darla Pruitt. Miss Southeast Georgia, Lisa Johnson. Lisa, how can we as a nation move toward full acceptance of the handicapped as contributing members of our society?
I believe that the first step in making the general public aware of how important these handicapped people are is to realize how important volunteerism is. I believe that if societies come together and work with these people, they'll refrain from a social posture of rejection and realize that each and every person should be created equal.
Thank you, Lisa. Her talent is a vocal performance of Can You Read My Mind? She is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Roger Lightsey and the late Donald Johnson. There you have Miss Southeast Georgia, Lisa Johnson. Miss Greater Atlanta, Colette Nolan. Colette, with less than half the registered voters participating in the last national election, how can we motivate apathetic Americans?
I believe very strongly that beginning with the third grade, we should instill a political science class all the way through high school. America has a tendency to take for granted the rights and the freedoms that we have. There are countries all over the world, from Eastern Europe to Soviet bloc countries, that are striving and even dying for the rights that we have here in America. And we have become very apathetic toward these rights. Very seldom do we stand back and really appreciate the rights that we have.
Thank you, Colette. Her talent is a vocal performance of If We Only Have Love. She is a daughter of Mr. and Mrs. A.J. Nolan. There you have Miss Greater Atlanta, Colette Nolan. Miss Rome, Melanie Helton. Melanie, in view of the controversy surrounding abortion, what viable alternatives would you offer to a pregnant teenager?
I would very strongly urge a pregnant teenager to consider adoption. There are so many families that would love to have a baby and cannot. And I think that we should not waste these babies with abortion. I think we should encourage our pregnant teenagers to consider adoption.
Thank you, Melanie. Her talent is a vocal presentation of Omeo Babino Caro. She is the daughter of Miss Linda Helton and Mr. David Helton. There you have Miss Rome, Melanie Helton. Miss DeKalb County, Melanie Hobbs. Melanie, what can we do to reverse the continuing deterioration of our environment?
The issue of environmental concerns is not one of what should be done, but rather one of what must be done if life is to continue as we know it today. Fluorocarbons are harming our Earth by a harmful radiation, and the temperature of the Earth has risen more in the past 30 years than in the previous 10,000 years, a result of global warming. It is my hope that all of our trees, including our family trees, may continue to flourish.
Thank you, Melanie. Her talent is a vocal performance of I've Got the Music in Me. She is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Charles Hobbs. There you have Miss DeKalb County, Melanie Hobbs.
Stay tuned for more of the 1990 Miss Georgia pageant right after this.
If you ever dreamed of wearing the Miss Georgia USA crown, your dream could come true. Special Occasions presents the Miss Southern Coastal Empire pageant. Entry deadlines vary, so register now for the only official preliminary to the Miss Georgia USA pageant. Any single Georgia resident ages 18 months to 26 years is eligible. Winners of teen and Miss categories advance to the state finals. Dreams really do come true, so register now at Special Occasions.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back our reigning Miss Georgia, Jamie Price.
Thank you. As nursing is to Kehlani, education is to me. And thanks to the Miss Georgia Corporation, I've been able to visit many schools, in fact, over 70 schools in the state of Georgia. And I present a program to the children. From many letters I've received, they have told me that now my favorite song is also their favorite song. So if you're listening tonight, I dedicate this to you. Because now you know, if your heart is in your dreams, no request is too extreme. When a star is born, they possess a gift or two. One of them is this: they have the power to make a wish come true.
But first, let's take one quick look back with former Miss Georgia Camille Bentley and the Miss Georgia Principals as they do a medley of songs from some past Miss Georgia shows. Then, we're headed for the future.
Oh,
On the day
crowning a new Miss Georgia, but first, ladies and gentlemen, let's greet one more time your reigning Miss Georgia, Jamie Price.
When a star is born, they possess a gift or two. One of them is this: they have the power to make a wish come true. My wish became a reality with the efforts of many generous and gracious people. Designers, retailers, photographers, franchises, and other special friends. My year has taken me numerous miles, both in and out of the state of Georgia. With this came the opportunity to meet countless extraordinary people. Without a doubt, my continued energies were derived from them, particularly from the younger generations. I am thankful to the communities for allowing me to be an active part of children's lives. For next year, at this time, I will devote myself full-time to better educating our youth. For he who helps a child helps humanity. To my dear Miss Georgia franchise friends, in the words of our fearless leader, the tears shed this week were not tears of sorrow because it's over, but tears of joy because it was. Oh yes, how can I forget Wendy? You're my hero. And to my mother, Nathan, and Aaron, I now realize and hope to continue helping others realize that if your heart is in your dreams, no request is too extreme. For when you wish upon a star, your dreams come true.
Jamie. We've completed all the competitions, and while the auditors are adding everything up, we have a very special award to present. It is my privilege to present a Quality of Life Scholarship Award brought to you by Fruit of the Loom, a major sponsor of the Miss America pageant. Now, the Fruit of the Loom Quality of Life Award will be presented to one winner from each state, as well as the winner from the national pageant in Atlantic City. These women have been selected because they have made significant contributions to improve the quality of life in their community through involvement in civic and charitable projects. On behalf of Fruit of the Loom, we are happy to present a $1,000 scholarship to Miss West Central Georgia, Debbie Cottrell.
Let us now bring back this year's 10 semifinalists, Miss Tifton, Kendra Tomlinson, Miss Armstrong State College, Natalie Hendricks, Miss Douglas County, Danann Sims, Miss Warner Robbins, Tony Henson, Miss Thomasville, Dean Peruse, Miss Northeast Georgia, Darla Pruitt, Miss Southeast Georgia, Lisa Johnson, Miss Greater Atlanta, Colette Nolan, Miss Rome, Melanie Helton, and Miss DeKalb County, Melanie Hobbs. Have the auditors completed their tabulations? Man, I hope so.
I do too. The moment of truth.
Here we go. Tonight's fourth runner-up and the winner of a $1,100 scholarship is Miss Armstrong State College, Natalie Hendricks.
Tonight's third runner-up and the winner of a $1,600 scholarship is Miss Douglas County, Danann Sims.
Tonight's second runner-up and the winner of a $2,200 scholarship is Miss Greater Atlanta, Colette Nolan.
Tonight's first runner-up and the winner of a $4,400 scholarship is Miss Thomasville, Dean Peruse.
The winner of a $9,000 scholarship and your new Miss Georgia is Miss Northeast Georgia, Darla Pruitt.
Miss America.